It is no surprise that period cravings kind of suck, but you might be making them worse and not even know it. In this video, we're gonna go over why we have period cravings, the scientific reasons why we get them, why our period cravings are so much worse when we're dieting, and I'm gonna give you practical steps that you can implement during your next period to handle those cravings. If you're new, welcome. I'm Colleen, a non-diet intuitive eating registered dietitian. Be sure to take a second and give this video a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button down there and the little bell to be notified every time a new video is uploaded. Also, leave a comment introducing yourself and let me know what your biggest period craving is. Mine is ice cream, but not like the chocolate ice cream. I like more of like the cookies and cream. So there's like a little bit of chocolate in there, but it's also got just kind of like that sweet vanilla-iness. That's my fave. And as always, guys, before we get into it, this video is for entertainment purposes only. It is not meant to be specific medical advice for you. If you do need medical advice or more information on anything that we discuss in this video, be sure to reach out to your medical provider immediately. Now let's do it. First, I need coffee. Okay, guys, so caffeination. The first thing that we need to know about period cravings is that they are totally normal, and this has to do for a lot of reasons, also due to our hormone shifts. So when we start our period, our estrogen is low, and that can actually stimulate your appetite. Also, our bodies are doing a lot of work during our periods. I mean, think about like how much tearing down and rebuilding is going on down there, and that needs energy coming from somewhere. Our cortisol can also be increased, so that's our stress hormone, and cause our body some extra sense of stress, which can also lead to that increased appetite and increased craving. And lastly, our serotonin drops during our period, and that is kind of that feel-good hormone. So if that's low, we wanna feel good, and that can kind of be, again, a driver for those cravings, like especially that cookies and cream ice cream that I talked about. So having those period cravings is totally normal. But when you compound that with dieting, it makes it way worse. Let me explain. So firstly, I talked about this in my video on thinking about food all the time, is that when we say that we can't have a food or that we shouldn't have a food, or even if we just label a food as good or bad, we're going to fixate on that bad food or what we're not letting ourselves eat. So if you are dieting during your period and you're having, let's go with that cookies and cream ice cream again, you're having that craving, you're saying, oh, I can't have that. It's kind of like telling a kid to not press the big red button. They're just gonna wanna press the big red button, or in this case, eat the ice cream, right? It literally increases your brain's response and reward system for that food. Also, another reason our period cravings could be heightened when we're dieting is because if we're not getting enough overall food, our brains are going to fixate on food. That's kind of a hunger cue, a drive for you to eat. That's kind of your body saying, hey, I'm not getting enough energy. I'm gonna make you fixate on this until you give it to me. Kind of think about it, if you have to pee, you're gonna start thinking, oh my gosh, I have to pee, I have to pee, I have to pee. Kind of the same thing with food. Now, there also have been studies that have shown things like tracking food or monitoring food. So activities where a lot of people do when dieting can increase our cortisol and our stress, which again could actually compound the cortisol increase that we may be experiencing on our period, causing even more stress-related cravings. Now, I have personally experienced this myself, but I literally see it happen every single day in my membership community, the society, where we take back that pull to eat those foods, that pull that is caused by dieting, right? So we have this, oh my gosh, you know, the ice cream's in the freezer, I shouldn't have it, I want it. We fixate on it, right? But when you allow yourself to make peace with food and become an intuitive eater, you take back that power, right? So for instance, I have, I think, 2 cartons of cookies and cream ice cream. One of them is like the really like expensive nice ice cream, and the other ones I think like $2 Aldi ice cream, which is delicious, don't get me wrong, but I don't fixate on them, right? They're there when I want them, they're there when I don't. And when I do allow myself to have them, it's not like, oh my gosh, I need to eat this whole pint right now. It's not like that binge eating tendencies. I do have a whole video on binge eating, I'll link to it up there for you, but that's really what happens when you become an intuitive eater, is you remove that pull, you take the power back from food, right? And again, when we pair that with period cravings, it's just like, I need this food now. Now, I know we always see on like Instagram these posts that say like, oh, if you're craving chocolate, you actually need almonds because your body needs magnesium or whatever. My stance on that is probably not. You're probably just craving chocolate. Now, don't get me wrong, nutrition is important. We're actually gonna go into, I'll give you a couple different scenarios of, you know, foods that you can include to help your period, but I feel like we are way overcomplicating this and we're almost using that as an excuse not to eat a certain food. It's a form of restriction, I think, is what it's being used as. Like I said, I'm not saying nutrition isn't important, but like sometimes if you're craving chocolate, you're just craving chocolate and we don't need to like dive super deep into that. Yes, you could allow yourself to include snacks of almonds and stuff, but it's not swapping them for each other. If you're having a craving, my advice is to honor that craving and do it mindfully, meaning like I'm experiencing this. I'm not just like shoveling it in my mouth, not feeling guilty over it and not wanting to have the experience. I think we think way too much into those stuff. So that's kind of my take on basically all that you see on Instagram with like swap this for this. Let me know what other ones you've heard of. Like I said, I think the almonds one is the biggest one that I've heard, but comment below. Let me know what other kind of like crazy swaps you've heard. And a lot of times when we have these period cravings, we crave those quick energy sources, right? So we crave carbs, we crave sugar, right? That is immediate energy for our bodies. And again, if you're compounding that with dieting, so you're having these period cravings while dieting, you're again causing your body to be like, okay, I just need energy. So you're gonna be even more likely to have period cravings for like carbs and sugar, right? And then compound that with saying that they're off limits, that you shouldn't have them. Guys, we are setting ourselves up to just go ham on these foods. It's all about neutralizing foods. And also, like I said, the serotonin drops and we want to feel good, right? So chocolate can give that to us. And I have a video on emotional eating I can also link for you guys, but emotional eating is not necessarily bad. I literally did it yesterday. I was having a crummy day and I made these cookies and I came home and I was like, oh, one of those just looks really good. I just need like some joy in my life. It was a day. So I had a cookie. Was I necessarily hungry at that moment? No, did, you know, but is it okay for me to eat that cookie? Abso-freaking-lutely. But here's the deal. I did not expect that cookie to fix my bad day. The issues that we're having with electricity and internet, the worst, right? They're still gonna be there, right? So I'm gonna have to deal with them. So it's not gonna, you know, eating cookies into oblivion is really not gonna do me any good, any benefit. So again, I'll link to that video for you, but emotional eating is a spectrum and it's not always bad. You can have food for a pick-me-up. Even when you're on your period, have some chocolate. Now let's dive into a little bit of the nutrition side of things because like I said, I'm a registered dietitian, right? And I'm a registered dietitian. Yes, I'm an intuitive eating dietitian, but I believe in nutrition science, right? I believe in the biology. I believe in vitamins, minerals, macronutrients, all of those things. Essentially in what I teach is gentle nutrition. So how do we go about implementing nutrition information in a way that's not obsessive, that doesn't control your life, that is quote unquote balance. I hate that word, but you know what I mean. So there are some different things that you can add into your diet. Again, this is not swapping. This is just kind of adding those things in to be like, okay, you know, there's some studies that show that this might help my period cravings. If I like that food, sure, I'll make a point to include it in my, when I, you know, have my period. So the first one is peanut butter. You guys know I'm a peanut butter fanatic, so I'm all about this one. It can actually help with mood swings and periods due to the vitamin B6 and the magnesium. Now, bananas can help with cramping and bloating because of their potassium and also their vitamin B6. Put some of that peanut butter on a banana and you got yourself like a period powerhouse snack. Iron sources are also really great to include because we do lose a lot of blood during our periods. So you can get iron from a variety of sources. There's heme iron and non-heme iron, animal versus plant sources. Animal sources are much more bioavailable, so our bodies are gonna readily use them more. So you can get that from, you know, meats are a really great source. So beef, turkey, chicken, those sorts of things. You could also find iron from tofu, dark green leafy veggies, or even iron fortified cereals or breads. Now vitamin D, I feel like vitamin D is like my favorite, but I don't like to play favorites with vitamins, but like vitamin D is a powerhouse in so many different ways. But in relation to our period, vitamin D has actually been linked to lower PMS symptoms. So you could try adding some salmon, have, you know, salmon for dinner, maybe pair it with some dark leafy greens and get your body some of that vitamin D and see if it helps with those PMS symptoms. The last one I want to talk about is chamomile tea. So this tea is used to treat PMS symptoms for a variety of reasons. It does have anti-inflammatory properties, anti-spasmatic effects, and also bonus points for the anti-anxiety effects. And I just think there's something to say about the comfort of like a warm cup of tea. Like that's soothing. And again, during our period, like we want relief, we want soothing. I also really recommend leaning into your period cravings. I do this, so it's almost like having the foods that you know you crave preemptively. So if you crave chocolate, put some cocoa powder in your smoothie, put some chocolate chips on your oatmeal, or pack a, you know, chocolate bar to have with lunch. Kind of just like set yourself up to almost like, I'm probably gonna crave this, so I'm gonna include it. That can make that pull, like that, oh my gosh, I need to eat this food, less, because your body's like, oh, I have it, that's great, thank you. It's not this like, oh my gosh, gotta get it now thing. That especially goes for guys if you tend to like binge eat those things. So when you allow yourself to get chocolate, this really goes with how I teach how to break your food rules and become an intuitive eater, is to normalize foods, plan them in. Essentially, it's exposure therapy. So kind of to sum up this whole video is, in order to reduce period cravings while dieting, I recommend not dieting and learning how to eat intuitively. Now, there's tons of misconceptions about intuitive eating. It is not just eating donuts all day long, guys. I'm a registered dietitian. I care about your health. I consider myself to be like the queen of intuitive eating, gentle nutrition. Like, that is my jam, because like I said, I am a registered dietitian. I care about nutrition. I believe in it, but you can also eat intuitively and not in a way that is dieting, and do it in a way that feels good both mentally and physically. That's literally what I talk about, you guys. So be sure to subscribe if you're not. There's way more content on that, right? Gentle nutrition all the way. Like I said, all those foods that we talked about that do have science back to them, if you like them, incorporate them. But if you hate salmon, like, don't force yourself to eat it. But maybe there's another food with vitamin D that you do, or maybe you decide to do one of the other things. Maybe you're like, I'll, you know, put some peanut butter on my toast in the morning, and that will be my gentle nutrition. Every person is going to be different. Intuitive eating and gentle nutrition is so individualized. If you do want to learn more about this whole idea of intuitive eating, or maybe you've tried it and you're like, I feel like I just don't get it, or I'm not sure if it's for me, be sure I have a quiz that you can take, which there's really three common things that hold people back from truly embracing intuitive eating. They're what I call ultra careful eating, all or nothing eating, and fearing of implementing gentle nutrition. So be sure to take that quiz. It's gonna help you identify what's holding you back. And I'm also gonna give you a personalized workbook to help you overcome it, and tons more resources. Okay, so I'll link to that in the description for you guys to take. And let me know in the comments if this video was helpful, what you think about your period cravings, or what you think about intuitive eating in general. Okay. All right, guys, I will be back here next week with another video, 11 a.m. Eastern time. See you later.